2005 Machinima Film Festival with Paul Marino. Paul, tell us a little bit about Machinima and why it's such a phenomenon.
Machinima has become a really important part of our culture because it mixes film and games. And games are, of course, kind of becoming more and more important part of our culture. And films are, of course, always been an important part of our culture. And Machinima kind of represents the merging of the two. So it's been a great kind of thing where people can kind of express themselves using the games they play a lot.
When you first started, did you feel as though, as a director, that it was going to be so popular?
Oh, I definitely had a sense of that. It was, it was very easy to see how gaming was going to become as popular as it is, and filmmaking has just like kind of always been there. So it was very easy to see how those two things would merge together, and just seeing how popular the games are slowly becoming over the years, it was inevitable that Machinima was going to be right behind it.
Do you feel as though Machinima has to do a lot with the popularity of the games as far as the marketing? Can it actually be combined?
It can be. I think that this has kind of been a launch-off point for Machinima. You know, the games kind of started off, and then it's kind of like, well, we can be independent filmmakers using these games. How do we take it from that point to being just kind of a standalone film? So Machinima definitely has its potential to be something on it that's stand on its own.
Now, for some people who are not familiar with this form of filmmaking, what are some kind of films that are actually being made, like dramas? Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, yeah, Machinima is very much like any film, like filmmaking in general. There's a lot of films. There's films that are dramas. There's comedies. There's talk shows. There's documentaries. I mean, it's like filmmaking. It's almost exactly like it. And some of them are. It's like filmmaking in general. It's hit or miss. But people find it as a way to creatively express themselves. So even if that's somebody's personal diary of how like they lost a parent, or if it's actually a way to tell this really funny story to them for themselves, it provides a viewable journal of a person's vision. So it's where its power is.
Where's Machinima right now, and where's Machinima going?
Machinima right now is in its adolescent stage. We have some growing to do, but it's got a lot of potential. You can kind of see how it's becoming this young adult, and you kind of like anticipate how it's going to be this great person as it grows up. And when it does get there, it's going to be like just something to be reckoned with. It's going to definitely affect both filmmaking and animation. So
how do you feel being a part of that?
It's really interesting. It's kind of alien almost. You know, we started this event like maybe 3 years ago, and it was kind of a very small thing that happened in a club. And now we're in a museum in New York, so even being at that level has been kind of odd. But it's been great. I mean, smiling all the way. So, it's kind of like, all right, I'm on this path, and, how much further is it going to take me, and how much more exciting is it going to get?
Who are some of your fans? What is your fan base looking like, the demographic?
It's similar to games, of course, but it's starting to open up. We're starting to get a lot more people interested in this type of work, both as filmmakers and as audience, people who find that Machinima filmmaking is a way of creating or entertainment that doesn't really come in any other form. So it's starting to expand, and that's kind of mirroring how the game culture is expanding as well. Now everybody's almost played some game at some time and just really likes that entertainment.
Tell us about the school.
It's still fledgling. It's still a very young, small entity. We're just getting started off the ground. Right now it's kind of a virtual entity. We do presentations and different types of events at institutions around the country. So we're like kind of a traveling school to a certain degree. I'll go to a college and teach Machinima for a day or two. We've had interest in being more fortified in an actual brick and mortar place. So there's actually an entity that's called a school, like academy. So we'll see what happens in the next couple of years, but that's definitely our intention.
How do you feel about industries actually taking notice?
that's really cool. I mean, that's really like one of the really things that puts a smile on my face, because a lot of previously it's been kind of like, oh, there's people doing these silly films and the silly games, and all of a sudden people are like, hey, these guys are really serious about this stuff, and the stuff that they're doing is pretty damn impressive. So, and that, you know, it's kind of like something we've seen all this time, and finally someone's taken notice. So it's really kind of cool to see that industry's kind of like saying, okay, these guys are really onto something.
Drop some names about the movies that you directed.
I did a video called I'm Still Seeing Green, which is a music video in Half-Life that was shown on MTV too. And I did a whole slew of films with the Ill Clan based on Larry and Lenny Lumberjack characters. So those are my... Oh, and then I also worked on the Strangerhood stuff with for an independent film channel. So with Rooster Teeth. So that was a lot of fun. It was a very fun project.
What else has been the works for Paul Marino?
That's a good question. I don't have anything specific going right now, but definitely there's something cooking for 2006. So you'll see some stuff from me then, for sure.
Is the festival going to get bigger? Is it going to be here again, or is it going to be, who knows?
Why are you asking me all these really on the spot questions? Yes, we're definitely going to be a larger festival. We definitely see it that way. Will we be the Sundance of Machinima? That's our intention. So will it be here or in Utah? No, it'll definitely stay in New York. We're a New York-based company. We want it to be in New York, and we definitely want a large turnout. And this today definitely represents part of that. So yeah, it's really great.
If people want to get more information about Machinima, what website can they log on to?
They can look at machinima.org. That's our website. There's definitely some information they can find out there. There's also machinima.com, which has most of the films as well as some tutorials and things like that people can get started with. There's a lot of different sites out there that kind of show off what Machinima is about and how people can get involved with it. So machinima.org and .com are probably the most important ones to start off with.
And it's important to think outside of the box and be creative.
That's right. Exactly. We you know, the people that are doing Machinima know that. You know, they see that there's potential that's outside that box. And of course, the next thing is like, okay, I can do it with this game. So definitely outside thinking people.
And the most important thing is that you can do it too.
This land of me.